New to my channel, I do air fryer videos every Friday or every other Friday, and I have made a bunch of meals in my air fryer. And one of the ones that I should have probably just left it on the video is when I was making my omelets, they went all over my air fryer. Thank you for coming back to my channel. I'm Stephanie, if you're new here. I know a lot of you guys know me from doing air fryer videos, but today is gonna be a different video, as you can tell from the title. I just wanted to go over some stuff with using an air fryer, and I want to share some things that you might be doing wrong with your air fryer. So I just wanted to give you some 5 top tips. Some of the things in my air fryer I still have not used, like a lot of the buttons that are on the air fryer. The only thing, one that I think that we use the most is the french fry one and the shrimp one. I think that's like the main one that we use. I would love to do the dehydration one, but it seems to be like a long process, like a couple of days to do. And I'm not sure I can get a video in with that, because then I won't be able to use my air fryer. I almost need 2 air fryers in this house because we use it that often. Some of the things that I want to cook for you guys are just things that I find different and unique than things that you wouldn't think that you could even put in an air fryer. So we've been having fun with that. Hopefully you guys liked my last pumpkin recipe in the air fryer. That one, I'm surprised it even turned out, actually, because some of the other things, we were doing like mini pies in the air fryer, and I wanted to do a full one. So I'm so happy that it turned out. It actually turned out really good. So you guys need to try that one, because that was awesome. But let's get back to the main reason why you guys are watching this video and some of the things that you might be doing wrong with your air fryer. We're gonna start with number 5, and we're gonna work our way down. The first one is overcrowding. When we put our bag, or actually sometimes my kids just do it, but they'll put a whole bag of french fry in there, and a lot of times it doesn't get cooked the right way because it doesn't have enough airflow through your air fryer to be able to cook all the fries at one time. So it's better to just do batches if possible. We do have the bigger size air fryer, so we're able to get a lot more in there. So if you're watching some of my air fryer videos and you're like, I can't get a whole chicken in my air fryer, that's just because we have a bigger size air fryer. I only know the one that I have. It's a Power XL. So that's the one that we've been doing a lot of videos on. So hopefully that makes sense. But overcrowding is probably one of the biggest ones that a lot of people are like, my meals aren't turning out. Things are soggy. They're not, you know, crispy. Yep. Number 4. One of the things that you might be doing wrong with your air fryer is not cleaning your air fryer. Some people have come ask me, they're like, you know, I have a lot of this on it. I have a lot of grease build up. When I made our chicken that one time, I mean, there was so much like grease and smoke in there. You could cut that down by maybe putting a piece of foil or something tucked around, or some way where, you know, you're not going to have that grease flying around. But your coil inside, like my coil, if you were to look inside or tip it upside down, you would see that it's like on the upper part. And so what I do for cleaning is I clean my air fryer out every single time that I use it. Just because if I'm cooking shrimp, I don't want to make that with like a sweet treat or something like that. So what I do is, if your air fryer basket is able to be put in the dishwasher, go ahead and do that. I have a little bit of a distraction here because Evelyn's going to join us today. So cleaning your air fryer is number 1 issue. Not having like a good turnout with your meals. With your air fryer, like I said, you can either put it in your dishwasher, the basket part, on your coil with some soapy water. If you guys are not into like soap or chemicals on there, just take some warm water with some vinegar and wipe your coil down. Now, don't do it when your coil is hot. You'll end up breaking your element on for your heating coil. Number 3. One of the things that we do wrong with using an air fryer, or you might be doing wrong, prepping in advance for meals that you need to have done. Are you coating them with the things that you need to coat them with? Are you doing, you know, like an egg mixture with chicken? Are you preparing ahead of time before you use your air fryer? When I made my pumpkin pie, I had to let the pie crust out 15 to 20 minutes before I cooked. So make sure that you have enough time. If you need to experiment with cooking with your air fryer, then experiment. I have times where I've done a meal and I had to dump it because it just didn't work. So just with air fryers, they can be very easy to use. They're very convenient, very fast in cooking. But if you're not prepared and you don't have everything ready, some of the meals aren't going to work the way you had planned. On to number 2, things you shouldn't do while using your air fryer. And that is not preheating. I know a lot of my videos I have been preheating, and some of my videos I have not. I think it depends on your preference and how fast you want to get your meal done. So a lot of times I don't preheat. Now, if you guys are following a strict recipe and it says preheat, then preheat, because there's a reason to why you need to preheat. Some of the meals that go into the air fryer needed to be hot already. You need to kind of keep track of that on your recipes. And I will label that. I think I have in some of my other recipes where I have said preheat or don't preheat, or I'll say I'm not going to preheat today. So as for number one, things you shouldn't be doing while using your air fryer is checking your timing. I keep saying this in all of my videos. I know in my beginning videos, I had a lot of people that are like, you know, your food is overcooked or things look burnt or whatever. You just really need to make sure that you are checking your timing. Like I said, you cannot walk away from an air fryer. You need to stay near it and check it at all times. You can have a recipe that says set your air fryer to 350, 15 minutes in cook time, flip it halfway in between. That would be another one I should have added to this, is flipping your meals. Some of your meals don't need to be flipped, and some of them do. They call them tossing and stuff. So I just usually have my kids take out the basket and give it a good shake, and things get flopped around and things get cooked. So make sure you guys are doing that also, so it has, it's able to cook everything in there. Okay, so as for your cooking time, if you have something that says 350 and you need to cook it for 15 minutes, that doesn't mean that you're gonna cook it for 15 minutes. You might end up burning things by 15 minutes. So make sure you check it within 5 to 10 minutes. If you know that the temp is supposed to be a certain temp and it's not lining up right with other things, then you need to change things around. This is probably like the biggest mistake that anybody could do while using their air fryer, is not using the right spray or spray on your meals. If you're using like making chicken breasts or chicken or egg rolls, things that have like a coating, or things that are kind of more raw, them are the ones that really need a good spray or spraying with cooking in the air fryer. That's what's gonna get you that nice crisp coating on it. So you're gonna wanna make sure you are doing that. I know in my last air fryer that I got, I ended up getting like an oil can or oil spraying thing, and that isn't working as good as I would like it to. So I'm just so used to just buying a can from Walmart or whatever and just using a spray can that way. So make sure you always have spray on hand, because that's one of the benefits of having a nice crusty coat on your food. Now if you're doing like frozen foods and frozen meals and stuff, you do not need to put a spray on anything that's frozen. That's really not going to benefit you. That stuff cooks anyways. You get a nice crisp like french fries and stuff without having to spray them. But if you were gonna make like fresh potato fries, then you're gonna want to coat them with oil, and that's what's gonna get you that crispiness with your fries. So make sure you are really knowing what you can put spray on and what you shouldn't put spray on. New to my channel, I do air fryer videos every Friday or every other Friday, and I have made a bunch of meals in my air fryer, and one of the ones that I should have probably just left it on the video is when I was making my omelets, they went all over my air fryer. I needed to clean out everything before I shared that video with you guys. I should have made that into a blooper or something. I should maybe make some blooper air fryer videos, but I do add some bloopers at the end on some of the things that I say completely wrong, or like, there's just things that I'm trying to do with kids around me and I mess up. But one of the things with your air fryer that you want to do is, if you are air frying anything with liquids, and if your air fryer is just like mine, you're going to know that liquids fly because you have airflow going through your air fryer. So I learned from my experience with that one, and I ended up using a piece of foil on top I think I put some slits in the top just for a little bit of airflow in there, but that's when I made my omelet in there. And then I recently did scrambled eggs, so I think I did that with that one too. I would have to refer back to the video too, but the things that I've used foil. But I did have people question, like, is it safe to have foil in there? As long as you have things in there, like you can have parchment paper in there. You can have anything that you can put in the stove. You can put in your air fryer. You just have to make sure that it doesn't fly around and hit your heating element. Like my heating element is up on top. I think I told you in some of the other things just before that mine is up on top, so anything that flies is going to go right into my heating element. So you just want to make sure that you have something covering it when you are cooking liquids. Otherwise, you can cook liquids in the air fryer. You just got to make sure that you are covering them the right way. Make sure you follow the recipe the way it recommends. I've been just trying to experiment as much as possible with things in my air fryer. So everything so far has turned out, besides some of the things that was a complete disaster, but we ended up mastering it and making it work. So with the pumpkin recipe, that one actually was really easy to do. That one turned out really good too, with us having the crust on top, and it wasn't, it actually cooked really, really nice, and I was really surprised with that. But to give you guys another like added bonus, I know this video is getting a little long, but another added bonus, when I made the crust, what I needed to do was just spray the pan, put the bottom pie crust in, spray that, and then put that in for a good maybe like 3 to 4 minutes until that crust had like a coat of, you know, just not brown, just, you know, a couple minutes of cooking time. Then put your filling in, put your top on, and then I think the crust would have been a little bit more flaky. So that's a big mistake that I did with that. If you guys have any more questions with things that you might be doing wrong with your air fryer, or things that are just not working with your air fryer, or things that you just didn't know that you could use with your air fryer, or that I can help you with that, give me a big thumbs up. That lets YouTube know that you guys are enjoying my videos. Don't forget to subscribe, because then you won't miss out on my other air fryer videos. I know I do a lot of other videos in between my air fryers videos, so hopefully you guys are enjoying them. And I will be having another air fryer video just like this video coming out soon. So I'm going to do this one first, and then I'll have the other one at another time. I'm going to throw this one in somewhere in the mix, so you guys will see this too. But other than that, guys, I'll see you in the next one.